The men entering a building in Nairobi through the basement. Aden Dek from Somalia and Kenya's Abdikadir Haret Mohammed arrive at a bank to complete a transaction to purchase the car allegedly used to transport the terrorists, explosives and weapons to the mall. Police discover the car at the mall days after the attack. Inside the mall, CCTV footage shows just four men strolling through. They've been identified as Abubara Al-Sudani, Omar Naban, Katab Al-Kene, and one only identified as Umar. Omar Naban's brother was killed in Somalia in an attack by U.S. forces in 2009. Saleh Naban had been on the FBI's wanted list in connection with the 2002 attacks on a hotel and an Israeli airliner in his home city of Mombasa. He was reportedly one of the original members of the Al-Qaeda East Africa cell and is also believed to have been among the planners of the 1998 U.S. embassy bombings in Kenya and Tanzania. At least two of these men are known members of the Kenyan wing of Al-Shabaab, known as Al-Hijra. It is this involvement of young Kenyans in terror attacks that has raised fears and confirmation that they are heading to Somalia to fight alongside the Al-Qaeda-linked militant group. There are also reports that the U.S. raid in Somalia targeted a Kenyan of Somali origin known by the name Ikrima. Muslim rights organizations say they expected the backlash.
We see a deliberate attempt to fuel terrorism within the society.
It is not clear if any of those on the CCTV footage inside the mall escaped, but the Kenyan government says five attackers were killed inside the mall. Sarah Kimani, SABC News,